I think that is a clever idea. Random restarts. That was one of the ways that we got unstuck when we were in local Optima when we were doing optimization. Maybe this will also come in handy in this setting.
Yeah, I like the idea because I came up with it, but I can see a couple. but I can see a couple of problems with it.
Well, wait, you can't see a problem with it yet because it's not even clear what you meant. Or maybe that's the first problem.
Well, it was clear what I meant in my head. Now, if you're going to want my mouth to understand what my head meant, well, then you're just asking for too much. So I really kind of meant random restarts where you just kind of start it over and over and over again. The problem with that is it's already going to take a long time, you know, infinity, to get to a good answer. And we thought we might have this issue with randomized optimization. Certainly this is going to be a problem here. But it still feels like there's something we could do with the randomness idea that would help us to overcome this problem with using what we know and only using what we know.
All right. So I like that direction. So let's think a little bit about what that could mean. So random restarts was one idea that we had when we were talking in optimization about getting unstuck, which is let yourself get stuck. And then once you realize you're stuck, throw everything out and start over again.
Right.
And you're right, that's going to end up being really slow. But we had a different way of using randomness to get unstuck.
Ah.
In, for example, algorithms like...
simulated annealing.
That's what I was thinking about. Yeah, so simulated annealing, the idea in simulated annealing is that you take uphill steps, but occasionally you're willing to take a random downhill step.
Right.
So it's kind of this mixture of choosing randomly and using... what you know, what seems to be the best.
Right. And so, yeah, I can see that. So then the random restarts thing kind of works. If you, instead of it being a random restart, it's just a random action every once in a while.
Yeah. Excellent. All right. So simulated annealing-like approach says that we're going to take a random action, you know, sometimes. So then our exploration policy, our approximate policy, is going to be to, when we're in state S, figure out the best action in that state according to our estimate and take that with probability, I don't know, let's say 1 minus epsilon.
Mm-hmm.
And otherwise take a random action and see what happens.
With probability epsilon.
Yeah, that's what's left over. So.
Right, so that's why you had 1 minus epsilon because you want epsilon to be small. So epsilon is going to be, so every once in a while you will randomly act. Oh, and then that'll solve the simulated annealing problem. Or do what simulated annealing helps you with by just taking a random action in what looks like a bad direction, comparatively, sometimes. But it also means that you get to explore the whole space, and so you have a chance of actually learning the true Q.
Exactly. So, and yet most of the time we're spending, assuming epsilon is small, we're spending a lot of our time taking good actions, or actions that we think are good, but we're always holding out some probability of taking other actions to help us improve our Q hat.
So if you do that infinitely long, and this will let you visit SA an infinite number of times, as long as epsilon is greater than zero.
That's right, and that the MDP is connected, right? So there could be state action pairs that just can't ever be reached, in which case you won't reach them. But that's okay, because since you can't reach them, they really don't matter.
Yeah, they sort of don't exist.
Exactly. All right, so let's focus in on this a little bit more, because I think this is now the first idea that we've had for choosing actions that has the property that it will learn, and it will use what it learns.
I like that.